a blessed, wonderful, and exciting Sunday to all. Sa tanan nga ni Adinhi, sa atong sanctuary, and even those who are with us online. Atong pagmaya sa taga Singapore na nagsubaybay na itong karon, nag-online, pauban na itong karon, si Don Don. Na ata sa Canada, pauban ni Harvey, and even in America with Cynthia. And the rest of some discoverians throughout the world, and our members of the church throughout the world who are watching with us, joining us in our worship service this very morning. Today, again, let's talk about our overarching theme, the grace of God, ang gracia sa Dios. Oh, may anak kita sa Romans chapter 7, verses 1 to 12. Next Sunday will be the half of chapter 7, the book of Romans. Verses 1 to 12 talks about the revelation of sin and law. Ang pagpakita, ipakita ni Pablo kung unsa ang sala o ang balaod o ang Espiritu sa Dios na nagalihok sa tanan nga ubos sa iyang grasya. Let us focus on the Word of God found in Romans chapter 7, 1 to 12. Maghimong ta o responsive reading, ako ang mabasa sa una, sa italic, in yung mass congregation, and even those who are watching with us. Verse 1, Do you not know, brothers, for I am speaking to men who know the law, that the law has authority over man only as long as he lives. So then, if she marries another man while her husband is still alive, she is called an adulteress. But if her husband dies, she is released from the law and is not an adulteress, even though she marries another man. For when we were controlled by the sinful nature, the sinful passions aroused by the law were at work in our bodies, so that we bore fruit for death. What shall we say then? Is the law sin? Certainly not. Indeed, I would not have known what is sin was except through the law. For I would not have known what coveting really was if the law had not said, do not covet. Once I was alive apart from law, but when the commandment came, sin sprang to life and I died. For sin, seizing the opportunity afforded by the commandment, deceived me, and through the commandment put to death. Tanan? So then the law is holy, and the commandment is holy, righteous, and good. Salamat sa atong na pagbasa sa pulong sa Dios. Again, Romans chapter 7, verses 1 to 12 talks about the revelation of sin and the law versus the Spirit of God that lives in us under grace. For the past Sundays, Paul has been asking some questions, and he himself answered it. Like, shall we sin so that grace may abound? In chapter 6, verse 1, he himself in verse 2 said, by no means. And in chapter 7, chapter 6 verse 15. Ngayon na po siya sa libo on singing. It's a God forbid. And today in chapter 7 verse 7, doon ang usap sa ipangtanan. What shall we say then? Is the law of sin? Kung sa may ato'y kasukti, ang balaod sa laba? Siya sa mismo in verse 7 nag-ingon, certainly not. So, ang balaod dili ingon nga sala, kung dili inisya mato ni Pablo nagahatag o revelations, buod pa sa buod, naghatag o pagpadayag. So that si Pablo nag-isgot sa chapter 7 sa iyahang struggles against sin. When Paul talks about Romans chapter 7, wala siya nagunahuna sa iyahang future or maybe on his past, but he is talking about his present condition when he is no longer under the law but under grace. Manang ang mga tao mangutana, kung dili na kita under sa law, therefore, wala na yung buhaton pa nato sa pagtuman sa balaod. Si Pablo mingingon sa taga Roma, certainly not. Dili mo ipasabot na kung dili na kita under sa balaod, na kita sa grasya, ato ng isa likway o dili na nato tanaw ang balaod. Tungod kay doon siya tulo ka mga rason, nga nang ningin siya na ang balaod dili dawatan. Tungod kay una, ningin siya, ang balaod gives a revelation of the nature of sin. Ang balaod nagahatag o padayag may tungod kung unsa man di ay kining sala. Without the law, we cannot see and determine, and we will not know that we are sinning. So this means ang balaod may naghatag kanato o pagpadayag nga ingon ani nga atong buhaton sala di ay kana. In verse 7, mayon siya, what shall we say then? Is the law sin? Certainly not. Indeed, I would not have known what the sin was except through the law. Dili kuno kabalo si Pablo kung unsa ang sala kung wala musulti ang balaod. Buti pasabot, ang balaod may naghatag o description. Ang balaod may nagpadayag ng kinisiya sa lahat. Nagpadayag si Pablo, for I would not have known what coveting really was if the law had not said, do not covet. Dili ta makaibalo na covetousness is sin, kung wala mo yun ang balaod, thou shalt not covet. Dili ta makabalo ang pagpatay sa tao, sala, if the law does not say, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal. So ang balaod, matod ni Pablo, nagahatag siya o padayag, nga maukini ang nature sa sala. Sa verse 12, bihin siya na kini ka balaod, usa ka balaan, usa kini kasubok na balaan, matarong o maayo. The law is holy, righteous, and good. Verse 12, being siya, for sin seizing the opportunity afforded by the commandment, deceived me, and through the commandment put me to death. These are the statement of Paul that reveals unsa ang nature sa sala. Pinaagi sa balaod na kahibalo ka na kining gibuha sala og tungod kay sala kini niingon si Pablo, tungod din ang sala na ilad siya, di ba? Deceive is pangilad. O niya, kini nga maong nga sugo, maoy nakapahimo niya nga siya mamatay. Iyan disuplihan ang mga Kristohanon dito sa Roma. Nga kining maong nga balaod nagpakita kung unsa ang sala o sa paghimo nato ng sala, iya tangihigan tungod niini kita nangamatay sa atong sala. Mao kanay unang tuyo ni Pablo nga mean siya nga indeed or certainly the law is not sin because it is the law that said mao kanak sala kini siya sala kadto siya dili. So ang balaod may reflections, siya ang naghatag og padayag nato nga kini diay atong gihimo sala ni kini pod siya dili. O mao kini ang struggle ni Pablo in chapter 7. We'll go to that. Number 2, why Paul said that the law is certainly not sin? Because it releases us from the law of sin and death. Ipakita ni Pablo na tumon ani nga balaod, tumon ani nga sala, ipakita kita na girelease na kita gikan niini. O kini nga release, iya kining gihatag o figure of speech or analogy or gitawag na to metaphor sa relationship between husband and wife. So, let's take a look at sa relationship between husband and wife. If the man and woman submit themselves into marriage, they will sign up a contract. And this contract is called lifetime contract. So, ang kontrata kung ikaw magbinyo, it's a lifetime. Manang ingon na to, if you enter into marriage, you enter into a relationship of no return and no exchange. Once na maminyo na ka, hindi pwede nimo iulit ang imuhang bana or imong asawa. Dili pwede nimo alis lang ang imong bana or imong asawa. Look at verse 1. Paul said, do you not know, brothers, for I am speaking to men who know the law, that the law has authority over man only as long as he lives. So ang balaod, effectual siya, nimo og nako, as long as we live. Diba para o marriage? Na kung ikaw karon ikasal na, minsaan ka atubangan nako, ako'y nagkasal nimo, o atubangan sa mga tao na may attend sa mga kasal, may ka till death do us part. Ang kamatayon lamang may magkabulag kanimo kung ganako. Ingat si Pablo, mao ka na ang atong relasyon sa balaod. As long as ikaw nagkinabuhi pa sa balaod, ikaw ubos ni anang kontrata sa balaod. And what the law says, you need to obey and do it. Ikaduha. Another marriage metaphor is that death ends the contract. If the contract is lifetime, only death can separate us. Verse 2. For example, by law, a married woman is bound to her husband as long as he is alive. But if her husband dies, she is released from the law of marriage. So kung banag asawa, gikasal, o niya insaad ka, a lifetime ang atong togetherness, only death can separate us. Kung mamatay ang imong bana, babae, isulpihan ni Pablo niini. Mga babae, yan niya sa iglesia, kung mamatay na ang inyong bana, you are now free to marry another man. So this is a marriage principle nga dili ka pwede nga kung doon na kay bana or asawa, magkinahanglan ka o doon na kay ikawa o kabit. Because that is covetousness. Walay kabit sa akong mga sakinan, kanan from sick. Dili pwede nga naay side bit. Naay back sick. Dili pwede. That is the principle of marriage. Manini si Pablo, kung ikaw na naminyo sa balaod, di ka pwede nga mupuyo po ka sa grasya. Dili ka pwede nga mingin ka nga, oh, under mo ko sa balaod, pero under mo ko sa grace. Ngayon si Pablo, di na pwede. As long as mamatay ng imuhang partner, you are free to marry another one. So, mamatay sa imuhang partner din ni, aron ikaw, mubalihin dito. If we are married to the law, then we are free. But the third point here is, maski naka sa balaod, naghimot ang covetousness, duha akong itanaw. When we read the word of God, we are under law. Kung basa na punta lain, under na punta sa grace. So kung mupabor na to ang Biblia sa grace, we are under grace. Kung mupabor ang Biblia may tungkol sa balaod, we are under law. And that is the breach of contract. In marriage, kung ikaw adunay kabit, or iba ikaw naminyo, nilakaw ka sa lain nga dapat, o dito nagminyo ka, kung nanapok kay kontrata gipirmahan, since you have another contract originally here, which is for life, naghimo na po kaglayan contract din hinga bago, that is breach of contract. Wa pa gani na human din yung kontrata, naghimo na po kaglayan kontrata. Maunang matiha ka kung polygamy ay monogamy ni ay. Maunang matiha ka dito sa balaod nga buhi pa niyong asawa pero na nakailain lead-in, kalitin. Pwede ka makiha ni anak at tulang sa iyong mga abogado. And Paul is saying here, daghan pagani na to in verse 3, ingat siya. So then if she marries another man while her husband is still alive, she is called an adulteress. But if her husband dies, she is released from the law and is not adulteress even though she marries another man. So kung gusto ka na maminyong lain, patyasan ng imong partner. Ala, ilog-ilog sa imong asawa, parang nga kanimong kaligil, pwede na ka ma-legitimize ang imong kaligil. Hindi ba imong bana, hindi ka hubo, kahit na. Pagkan ang baboy, pahinon ng mga ilimnon ng matahubo, pahipag-drugs, kanan, ihatag, pero dali na mamatay. Diba, kaluhay sa hinahinayon ng patay ng iyong partner, kagigong ang luyos ng mga nauna, magminyong dahil ka sa babae na naanan ito ay mungkutang sa laging bago. Yan si Pablo, adulteress. Adulteros. Ingunala sa ang kinabuhin sa Kristohan. If you say you are married to the law, you remain in law and it will deceive you and it will put you death. But if you are married to the grace, we live by the grace of God and we are free to do His will. We are not obliged to do His will in order to earn His favor, but we are doing the will of God because it is His grace that enables us both to do and to will to perform His laws and commandments. Manang nagbibati si Pablo sa mga tao dito sa Roma, kay daghan pa mga tao sa Roma, naghuna-huna that they were under the law. But Paul said, no, we are under grace. And people are saying, pwede both. Anong papilihon ka, quantity or quality? Asa may magandahan, daghan mo, pero may kabang kaakad? Or gamay ra, pero full of wisdom? Kabagod sa nato, pwede mo both? Ang daghan ka ba niya full of wisdom? We need only to stick one. Either we are under law for we are under grace. So, the marriage metaphor is a very good illustration, an analogy of a relationship between the law and the grace. Mamatay sa tao na sa balaod ay hakta makamarry sa grasya. That's what Paul is talking here. Ang balaod mo produce og sala, ug sala mo produce og kamatayon. That is why Christ died on the cross as the end of the law. Ang kamatayon ni Kristo sa cross mo ay nagkapahunog nga ikaw namatay kauban kang Kristo, ikaw gibalhog kauban kang Kristo, ikaw na kinabuhi uban kang Kristo, dili na under the law but under the grace. Grabe ang discussion ni Pablo ni Amy. Gikan pa sa ubod sa chapter 1, hangtod karon chapter 7, sigit yako sa hisgot sa grasya, kaya mga tao, dili makaangkod ng atong kaluwasan, pagtuo lamang ang ikinahanglan. Ng atong pagkinabuhi ng Kristohanon, grasya lang sa Dios ang nagbunit ni mo nako. Para mga tao na may grasya, nangangisgrasya. Kapag kita nanahanga sa kamot sa Dios, magpuyo kita sa grasya sa Dios. Ikatulong, kung sa relationship sa Espiritu o sa atong lawas, the flesh, what's the relationship? And this is the struggle of Paul. And I know, di lang si Paul nag-struggle, ani ako o ikaw, but next Sunday, we will talk it deeply. Verse 6. But now, by dying to what once bound us, we have been released from the law, so that we serve in the new way of the Spirit, and not in the old way of the written code. Kung sa ning written code, makini ang balaod, the law. So may si Pablo, we are bounded, gigapos ta sa balaod, di ta makaikyas, kaya kontrata ta, doon ang tayo ipirmahan, doon ang kinahanglan, mamatay na ko, aron mahuman ang akong kontrata. Kaya hindi kamatay na ko, buhipon ko sa Diyos, and I have a new contract, and we call it the new covenant. Wala na ta in the old covenant. We never have a covenant for the Gentiles, but the Jews have their old covenant, and the Jews were transferred from the old covenant to the new covenant. And we Gentiles, we don't have covenant, we don't have laws. But here with Christ, we have the new covenant with the Lord. So once I'm in the dealing of flesh, the word flesh here is used in at least four different types and ways. Number one, flesh refers to the physical matter that makes up human bodies. When we say flesh, kini atong lawas. Nga, adunay unod. Ikaduha, the human body itself. Kuminta nga physical matter, mga unod, mga bukok, ang tanan, ang nato, itawag ng siya o flesh. Ikatulo, nga gamit, a human being or the human race. Kanang kaliwat nato nga tao, gikan ta kang adan sa atong mga katigulangan, hangtod ni apo, ikaw na anak, doon na kay anak, doon na kay apo. Baka na ikaw na the human race, pwede na itong tawagong ng flesh. Ikaapat na gamit is the rebellious human nature, and that is also flesh. And Paul here is talking about the flesh in number 4. Ang struggle ni Pablo, dili lang lawas na kamot, na bugat, kamot niya nasakit, porti il, nga gi-arthritis. O di ba, ang tibok niyang lawas, itapoy, kung sa kanyang yunahuna. O di ba, wasay nahimo kay, kung unsay, gihimo sa iyang amahan, lolo, lola, mausay na iyang imon. Paul here is talking about the rebellious human nature nga naasulog sa iyang kaugalingon. The struggles. Why? Tungod kay kita naana sa grasya, magkinabuhi na sa grasya, and yet doon na tayo lawas. na subject sa kalibutan, which is subject to the law and subject to sin, mo na siya'y makikaway na to day after day. Ang atong sala o ang atong espiritu na naa sa Diyos. And we believe that Christians have two nature. Doon na tayo old nature, doon na po tayo new nature. Let us have a contrast of these two paths. Doon na tayo duhapat. Itanaw na pag what is contrasts? Pag-indig. No? Pagpakita sa una o ikaduha. Now, number one, the contrast is the newness and the oldness. Ang imong pagkabag-o karon o ang imong pagkadaan sa una. And this is the struggle. Diba? Struggle din ato. Sa una, ganahan kay ka manumba, ganahan ka mahatag o mga daotan, na physical, na kadaotan. Pero karon kay naa ka sa grasya sa Dios, imong gipugnan. Mo na struggle na to. Ikaduha, ato pag contrast is between the spirit and the flesh. What I mean by flesh is the number four use, which is the human nature. A rebellious human nature. Kaya by nature, ang tao rebellious. Itawag na ito o rebelde. Sa pala yung tumo, term ang rebellious. Ha? Masino pa kong galing o. Diba? Ang pagkagahi o po na ito. Mauna kayo, mauna i-refer ni Pablo the rebellious human nature. Nag-struggle siya. Na naman, kay naapatadin ni sa kalibutan. We know that we are dead to sin. We are no longer under law. We are now under grace. But the struggle remains. Kaya ang pinaka number one na ito na kaaway mao ang atong lawas. And the flesh refers to the rebellious human nature. Kamita na ang bata, isulti sa itong mga ginikanan, nga ang bata magawas, kinangang pahilakon. In a medical science, kinangang pahilakon ang bata to know ang bata, kaginawa ang bata is active. Once na gili mo hilak ang bata, there is a problem. And that is the medical science. Managapupukon ang kamot sa bata, ito ali, pahilakon siya. Ano man kinangang siya react? So the medical staff will know what happened to the child. Ngano ba man yung hilak? Ngano ba man yung kisi-kisi? That is the medical side. But if you hear our old mothers and parents, ingon sila, ngano nihilak ang bata kung magawas sa taguangkan sa mama tungod kay siya makasasala? Asahan ka tuon niya ni in the medical side or surface sa itong mga kinikanan na ngano nihilak ang bata kay makasasala na ka? Another one, pagkadako-dako na sa inyong bata, may ka nga, asa ni kaliwat ng bata, ah, na grabe mang kasipat. Wadi mang kasipat, nga amahan. Ang mga san, wag at tuluan eh. Nga naman ganyang bata, na sipat pang dikayo. Nga mga silingan, wag po maka-influence siya kay, eh, mang kung may mga silingan, kay, mahadlok na sa'n eh, wag ganyang may kailagin siya ng mga silingan. So parents are wondering, what happened to my child? Nga naman nga isog mag-ibne, nga naman mo dili mag-iot, nga naman nga mo reveal mag-ihapot siya, isa may katudlo ni ini. Yung si Pablo, that's the use of the flesh, the rebellious human nature. By nature, we are rebellious against the will of God. This is the human system against or opposite to the spiritual systems of God. Mana ang kitawa ng contrasts? Struggle ka, gusto ko magbago, igsoon ang higala, dili ikaw ang mahimos kabaguhan sa iyong kinabuhi. Dili ikaw ang maling kamot na kinahan ng usap na ko sa iyong kaugalingon. It is the power of God, it is the grace of God that will enable us to perform the good things God wanted us to do. It is not us. That's why we have the struggles. Our minds are struggling. Wala ang battle sulod sa kasing-kasing. Wala ang battle sulod sa imong balay. Naa sa imong opisina. Wala. The struggle is within and inside in our minds. Because we know for the fact that we are dead to sin and we are alive in grace. Katapusan. Let us remember that we are under, that under grace means we are not under law. Ato lang yun ang sambalik-balikon. Kung mayon kita na balik-balik ng mga pastor, gagahan ang pagpuhak na ito sa balik-balik. Diba? Gusto ka ma-perfect, mag-practice. If you want to retain, make more repetitions. Balik-balikon na ito ang masulod yun sa ulo sa atong panunduhan. Manato mga anak, ato ingnon, sagilan ko anak, balik-balik ko para nimo morana ko o basak na soundbox o diba morana ko piyang-piyang amahon ang tuntuno o diba morana ko guba na plaka sa imong unahon at pagdumo. Pasagilan ko kay later on, I know the more you hear, the more you remember. The more you see, the more you remember. And when you remember things, you do it unknowingly. That's the underlying principle. But I do believe that yeah, these children who are here, those children whom we are ministering to, though they are young, when they grow up, they will not depart from it. If we invest in the lives of our children and our youth, ang investment nimo nako dili yun na siya masayang. For in due time, the words that we have planted in the hearts of these children, or the hearts of these young people, it will grow up. Magbalik-balik sa unang ito na kagantan ni anak. When they hear the sounds of the song they learn when they are young, may sila nga, uy, kamangura ba kong anak? And when they start to sing, pag yun nga, oh, ito na kami pares ko ng John 3:16. Asa na lang ako Biblia? When they start to read the Bible, they will start to grow as a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I repeat for the second time, we are not under law, but we are under grace. If we are under grace, if we have been discharged and cleared from the law, gihuman na nato ang kontrata. Kinsay gahuman sa kontrata? Si Kristo rito sa cross. He is the end of the law. Ingno na natang balaod. Ops, sala, human ako. You are not my boss anymore. Dili na ka, maoy na kontrata na ako. I have a new contract. I have a new covenant with the Lord Jesus Christ. And this covenant is the greatest of all covenants. We are cleared already. Cleared na po na ha? Ako na lang hindi papas na itong kontrata. Balaot, sala, wala na. Dili na po under name mo. Tignan ka mag-subaybay na ako. Wala na kailangan na ako na ako ibang mong kontrata. Mag-gracia sa Diyos and the new covenant. I hope you realize that. And because of that, we need to live by faith. And not upon the written code which is the law. Let us be by faith. Pasagli ang Ginoo ang trabaho sa iyo at akong kinabuhi. Dilita manigtamot para ang Ginoo mahimaya. Who are we to do things for the glory of God? We cannot do that. Menta nga ako ng himoon aron mahimaya ka, Lord. You cannot glorify God in that. Except if the Lord, through the power of the Holy Spirit, enable you to do the things for God that is acceptable unto Him. And that is the principle of grace. Dili kita. Dili tamang kamo. dili ka maghago. Kaya ang Ginoo, maoray mo, enable nimo, tagaan ka niyang kaalam, tagaan ka niyang puso, tagaan ka niyang panggasolina, tagaan ka niyang dakong sweldo, tagaan ka niyang dako na pahakanan parte sa imong ikahaguan para na ikaw mahimong panalangin. Kaya kung saan pagpanalangin nimo kung ikaw huwag panalanginin. Manang mabang tao, maning kamo, mahimong kani ang mahimong kong panalangin. Iyo ka ng doy. Kaya kung ang imong kita, may imong gamiton. Sayangan ka sa imong kwarta. Mayahaya man, ako'y naning kamo, walay tulong. Grabe, nakaroon imo ng pangayon, ibang hatag lang. Hayahaya man. But we are, if we are under grace, kung ikaw, kita ka grasya sa Ginoo, Lord, salamat sa grasya, unexpected grace, unexpected blessing, na-promote ka, huwag ka naging kamot na ikaw ma-promote, huwag ka naging kamot na ikaw tagalagapag-swildo, huwag ka naging kamot na ikaw mahimong supervisor, it is the power of God. That is why you can easily say, Lord, I offer to you my life. Lord, whatever you want me to do, I will do it. Why? Because it is the Lord that enable us and empower us and blesses us in order for us to be a blessing to the rest of the people's lives. The Lord will bless this church so that we will become a blessing. It is by the power under His grace and the grace of God will distance us from our previous contract, which is the law. Nalang ng law. Nalang ng sala. Mudiktar na ng sala nimo. Mag-struggle man ka kay good with me. Pero mag-struggle ka and the Lord will deliver you even from the snare of the followers. You visit our permitting messages. God will protect us even in our pandemic. God will not leave us empty, but will give us more something for us to enjoy the blessings. My dear friends, tanan nga sa online, receive the grace of God. Jesus is the end of the law. Kinahanglan ka, grasya, di ka kahimo sa iyong pagalingon. To draw near unto God by yourself, you cannot do it. We are dead. How can the dead can do something good? But if you wanted to be alive in God, receive Him as your Lord and Savior. Put Christ in your heart so that grace will abound to you. The more you're saved, the more is the blessings of God. For us, for under grace, let's continue leading God by our faith. Let's believe that God is there to protect us. God is there to be with us forever. He will never leave us nor forsake us. He is there waiting for you. Father God, pasalamatan ka na ang sinong kapulong. Salamat to Diyos pagpanalangin mo sinong kulong na matagusakan na mo. Even those who hear us and watching us, imo silang ipanalanginan. Imo kami ipanalanginan. And you are working in us both to do and to will for our glory. Bless us, Lord, as we continue our services to you. In Christ Jesus.